Hello guys, this is Ravens from Digi Integrity. Welcome to Tech News episode 103. OnePlus Note 6 5G pre-order start at 12 p.m. on 11 June. The OnePlus Note 6 5G starts at ₹22,999 for the base 6GB and 128GB in India. There is also a 8GB and 128GB variant priced at ₹24,999 and a 12GB RAM and 256GB variant priced at ₹27,999. The smartphone comes with a HDFC Bank cashback offer listed at ₹1,000 discount means that device can be purchased for ₹21,999 with the card offer. OnePlus has been teasing about the launch of its upcoming smart TV for a couple of weeks, and finally, the OnePlus TV U1S series goes officially in the Indian and global market. The newly launched OnePlus TV U1S series comes in 50-inch, 55-inch and 65-inch models. The highlighted features of the newly launched smart TV are sleek design, bezel-less display, Dyn Audio, HDR 10+ support and a 60Hz refresh rate. And these TVs are also said to offer around 95% screen-to-body ratio. Besides that, there is a set of microphones arranged in a row with 4 LED indicators placed right below the OnePlus logo in the middle. The microphones will be used for hand-free voice control. Under the hood, the smart TVs are being powered by the MediaTek processor along with 2GB of RAM and 16GB of storage. Now let's see about the prices. OnePlus U1S 50-inch smart TV is priced at ₹39,999. OnePlus U1S 55-inch smart TV is priced at ₹47,999, while 65-inch smart TV is priced at ₹62,999. The OnePlus TV U1S will be exclusively available on Amazon India, Flipkart and official website, and the company is also providing some offers on the TV. OnePlus Note 2 will be powered by a Dimensity 1200 processor and up to 12GB of RAM. The key upgrades will be in the processor, camera and battery departments. Earlier leaks have suggested better design and price compared to the original Note. Sony India has expanded its smart TV lineup in the country with the launch of its latest Bravia X90J. The company has launched the TV as the world's first cognitive intelligent TV series, which think like a human brain. The claims look promising, but we cannot say anything about the TV unless we review the device. According to the company, the smart TV comes equipped with cognitive processor XR, which is capable of delivering intelligence that reflects human cognitive characteristics. The Bravia X90J is launched in India with a starting price of ₹1,39,990 Indian rupees, and the smart TV will be available across all Sony centers, major electronic stores and e-commerce portals in India. According to the company, the smart TV will be available for grabs in India from 10 June 2021 onwards. Do note that new models in the X90J series with 75-inch and 65-inch will be announced soon. Vivo Y73 2021 price in India is set at ₹20,919. The phone comes with a 6.44-inch Full HD Plus AMOLED display, MediaTek Helio G95 processor and a 4000mAh battery. It comes with a 8GB of RAM and 128GB of storage. Vivo Y73 2021 will go on sale on Flipkart from June 12th and also available on offline retail stores. Facebook demonstrated a neural interface based wearable for controlling AR systems. Watch can be detached from case and could pack 2 cameras. Facebook reportedly in talks with cellular carriers for LTE support. Smartwatch could be priced around $400 and run on custom Android skin. Move could help Facebook regain control over data collection practices. Apple already controls a large chunk of global smartwatch sales. Logitech Slim Folio Pro keyboard for iPad Pro models launched in India. Price starts at ₹11,995. Logitech adds the Slim Folio Pro is specifically designed for 3rd and 4th generation Apple iPad Pro models. The case with the keyboard does not include a trackpad. Microsoft said that it is building a own game streaming device and working with TV manufacturer to embed Xbox Game Pass subscription service into smart TVs with no extra hardware except a controller. The global smartphone shipments are expected to reach over 650 million units in the first half of this year, with the first and second quarter likely registering double-digit growth on year-on-year sale. Honor 50 Pro benchmarked on Antutu website with Snapdragon 778G processor and more specifications have been revealed. The top-tier model of the lineup, RNA AN00, has been benchmarked by popular benchmarking app Antutu. The 50 Pro scored just shy of 526K for its run. The phone will debut running with Snapdragon 778G chipset and Adreno 642L GPU. It is also paired with 8GB of LPDDR4X RAM and 256GB of storage. Samsung has announced the first mobile image sensor, the ISOCELL Slim JN150 megapixel, that adopts the smallest pixel size in the industry at 0.64 mm. The 50 megapixel sensor uses advanced ISOCELL 2.0, smart ISO and double super PDAF technology and comes with a 0.64 mm sized pixels in a super small package for much slimmer ultra-high resolution cameras in mid-range to flagship smartphone with a 10% thinner camera module. Electronic Arts EA has officially unveiled Battlefield 2042 via reveal trailer. It is a multiplayer only game and will pit you against up to 128 players on next-gen consoles. Battlefield 2042 price in India is set at ₹3,499 for PC and ₹4,499 for PS5 and Xbox One X. Deezo Watch is the first brand in Realme Tech Life ecosystem. It comes with a 3.5 cm that is 1.4 inch high resolution touchscreen. It has a 12 days battery life and it comes with a 90 different sport modes and it also supports the IP68 water resistant. It has a blood oxygen and heart rate monitor. It also supports a live watch faces feature as well. It has another smart feature called Smart AIoT control that helps us to do the control center for your Realme AIoT devices such as headphones. Again from the Deezo, we are going to see GoPods, and again it's a true wireless earphones from the Realme TechLife ecosystem. It comes with a feature of active noise cancellation. It runs on 25 hours total playback. It has a transparency mode and a 10mm hi-fi bass boost driver. We can also see dual mic noise cancellation for calls. From the Deezo, we are going to see GoPods D in the Realme TechLife ecosystem. It is a true wireless earphones. It comes with a 10mm bass boost driver. It runs on 20 hours total playback. It connects via Bluetooth 5.0. It has an environmental noise cancellation for calls. Realme has officially announced that its latest GT Neo model of smartphone crosses over 500,000 units in sale. The device was first made available for sale back in April 2021. The Android Authority has obtained exclusive photos of the first laptop from BBK Electronics, the parent company of OnePlus, Oppo and others. The laptop will feature a 3:2 aspect ratio screen and a design that looks heavily inspired by the Apple's MacBook. The laptop was first teased on Twitter recently by the Realme's India and Europe CEO. The Realme Book laptop seems like another step forward toward diversification. Realme RMX 3366 is known as Realme X9 Live Images has been spotted on TINA certification. The device is tipped to feature a 6.5 inch display and a triple camera setup. Xiaomi says that Redmi Note 10 series crosses rupees 3000 crore in sales in India since its launch. Xiaomi has sold over 1 million units of Redmi Note 10 series smartphone in just 9 days after the device went on sale in China. In the first hour of the sale, the volume exceeded 500,000 units and it is said by the company. Xiaomi India celebrates selling Mi 11X units worth $41 million, that is 300 crore Indian rupees, in just 45 days of its launch. Xiaomi has been just granted a new patent earlier this week. This new patent is related to augmented reality application with the technology having product evaluation based capabilities. This AR device will capture a targeted item through its camera module, after which it will begin mapping the product and offer the user information based on the appearance of the item. So we can expect this technology to be supplemented by object mapping systems that offers item identification capabilities to the device. Unfortunately, it is currently unknown if the company is actually working on such a system or covering all bases. Xiaomi offers several smartwatch options for buyers in China. All the Mi watches available so far can be charged using magnetic dock charging. Fresh information reveals that the company could be working on a new smartwatch that carries support for wireless charging. The Chinese text on the top reads wireless reverse charging and then it shows the watch placed on the back of a Mi smartphone. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.